Hi everyone, welcome back. If you are a subscriber, thank you for subscribing, and welcome if you're not a subscriber, and I hope you like and you do subscribe, and I'll keep doing them. Today I'm going to have a little bit of a play around. Now, my son has asked me to do a stormy sky, and he'd quite like some lightning. So I'd have no idea how this is going to work out or not, but we're going to give it a go and have some fun. I put a very a thin layer of liquid clear on here at the moment. So that's it. Let's get going. See what happens. Right, so on my little palette, I've got some colours already. I've got a load of white. I've got a touch of yellow because I want a touch of yellow in the background of the lightning. I've got some ultramarine, some phthalo blue, some black, and some alizarin crimson. So with those, we should be able to do a sky. Let's give it a go. I've got lots of new, brand new brushes as well, so I'm quite excited about that. A little bit of my paint cleaner in here. Okay, now remember, you need to commit. So I'm going to go for it with this brush. So I'm going to want some light area, so I'm going to go white first, put base level of white in. Now, I'm going to mix up a little blue, a little crimson, a bit of that. I'm going to try to create some slightly different shadows. I don't want them all dark, I will want some dark, but I want that lovely lavender again. I had, and then I'm going to take a touch of the white to mix. Okay, yeah, there we go. Right, let's go for some of this. I might do a shadow reflection again, so put some in here. Okay, a bit darker, same colour. Thank you. for the darker clouds, and then some areas where the light can come through. And I'll probably put the lightning here. Right, let's blend this in, shall we? Now, I am going to make this patch slightly lighter. A bit of light blue in there. My brushes are molting today. Okay. Had to shut the window because the actual rain was coming in. Right. Now I'm going to get my... and a brush over the top. Right, no, I'm not. I'm going to go straight in with some white. So, which brush? I got some new brushes for my birthday. Nice new ones. Let's go for it. Let's highlight. This one. darker patches. Could go a bit darker here, I think. Fluffing them a bit, making them a bit fluffy. I like that patch, so I'm going to leave that. Okay. Quite happy with that. Just going to put a touch of white on the top. Just to gently bring out some of the clouds, just highlight them a wee little bit. Put a bit on this one here. Just going to highlight a few individuals. So the idea being that this is a lighter background, so it's still daylight, but then you've got the storm clouds rolling in. So that's why that's lighter in the background. It might need a bit more blue though, because I want the lightning to stand out. Blend it a bit more. Yeah, I think I'm quite happy with that. I will put some trees in and do this water because it's quite nice seeing the reflection. So I've already got enough there. Do I need a bit more here? I think I do. Make it a bit darker. A bit more blue though. Think it might come from? Do we think it's... I did say I was going to put it here. Maybe I'll put a bit here and a bit up here. I think I'll put it here and see how it looks. If it's a disaster, then I won't. I'll put it where I need. I still think that might need to be a touch darker here to see lightning. Maybe I'll put it up here instead. It's quite a nice colour. Let's try here. Let's try up here. From this bit here. Give it a whirl. Right, remember, I'm hesitating. I need to commit, so I'm going to follow my own advice. I'm going to commit. Right, so I'm going to take this one. Actually, palette knife might be best, mightn't it? Okay, so this one's creating some lightning. We're going to end up having more light here. streak of lightning over the top. So this isn't the actual lightning, this is the light behind it. Right, now I need a very fine brush and I'm going to mix a bit of yellow in. Sounds like lightning. I enjoyed doing that actually. Touch. Bring this back up a bit. I think I'm quite fancy doing another one. Where should we put it? Do more this side, or should I try one up here? Should do it up here. Let's go here. Okay. A lighter patch. the same. Right. And that, so that's just a background highlight. And I'll come back with my scratchy brush. You seem to work quite nicely, actually. was thinking that lightning would be lighting up this cloud down here a little bit. Needs to be a bit lighter. Oh, there we go. Sorry. Do not do another one. Don't want to overdo it. I think I might just stick with those two for the time being. Yeah. So I need to do something about here now. Don't want to detract from the sky. So I think I'll just put some low-lying land in the background. I think that's probably better. Another palette here. What do I need? I've already got some black. So I think I'll go burnt umber. Some burnt umber and some black. A bit of white is snuck into there, but that's okay. And way too much black there. Oops. There. What's that colour? Oh, I've picked up blue. Burnt umber, that's what we want. We want brown. And then we want some black, so I'll put a little bit in, not as much as I did last time. Trees, and then I might leave that clear. Yeah. And then I need, if I was going to do that, I should have. You can put like tape in to make a horizon line, but I haven't actually got a horizon line, so I am going to put trees in. I'll just put a row of trees coming down, and then. Yeah. quite small trees in the background, are far away. So they could just reflect it. That's as tall as they are. That's a reflection, so they're not very big. Sure, the trees are actually sitting on some land, not just floating. Oh, yeah. Okay, I think that's quite good as it is actually, but I'll put a little lightener on these ones. Lightener for the lightning. Because they want to be slightly more lit up. This side of the tree. The light, won't it? Be a bit lighter. Okay, and I'm going to pull that down and move it across, but wondering whether we can put a reflection in here. Give it a go. Why not? The beauty is the way that it boils. I'm going to put in a reflection here. If it doesn't work, it can blend it out. Worth a go. So, where is my little bit of brush here, so that's dark. It's a bit lighter here. This bit here. Okay. That bit's there. And that bit's here. Like that. Yeah. And a bit lighter here, actually, isn't it? Now I'm going to pull and go. No, I'm not. I'm going to do the lightning first. And just see how that goes. So, I'm happy with the blending here. Yeah. There's a lot of patches here. And it's a lot of... Yeah. Yellow. Right. Put things upside down. So we're coming up here. Like this. No, like that. No, hang on. There, like that. And like that. use my scratchy brush again, I think.
It's easier.
So I'm going to pull down first. Okay. That's all right. Now, this bit, see what we think of this. What do we think? I think that's all right. A bit of blending out. We need the crack of the lightning, don't we? So it might be reflected. Yeah. I like. So for the waterline on the back, I'm just going to use the brown mixed with a bit of the white to make it lighter. just to help with this. And I'm going to put some ripples here. I'm enjoying this. Got myself all lost in thinking about lightning. I like the light here. When the storm comes, there's still lightness. That's true in many a thing in life. I'm going to mix a bit of that, the lavender colour with the white. distinguish between the lightning reflections. So I think I'm happy with that. Yeah, let me turn it around. There we are. My first lightning thunder scene. I'm quite proud of that. Nice little reminder that even if you can't see the sun, it's always there, hidden behind. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please subscribe. I'm going to keep doing them as often as I can. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you.